When it comes to data recovery, having flexibility is key, especially when you're faced with different types of data loss events. In this demo, we're going to walk through the different recovery options available within the Veeam Data Platform. Okay, so here we are in the Veeam Data Platform. There are two ways that you can get to the Restore Wizard. So the first way is up on this top toolbar. So you can see there you have this Restore icon here, and this will go ahead and take you through the type of recovery that you want to perform for a specific workload. The other way is if you go to your backups, and if you were to expand one of your backup jobs and highlight the virtual machine that has a backup of it, you can right-click on that and you'll have all of your options for recoveries. So the first one that you see up here is Instant Recovery, and that is the pioneer technology that Veeam has been known for. So Instant Recovery gives you that temporary state where we can go ahead and take a backup file, we can mount it, present it back to our hypervisor host, and get it back online as quick as possible without having to wait for that migration process of moving the backup file and converting it back to a virtual machine image. So this will go ahead and give you the fastest option to get your data back and online as quick as possible. Your next one is going to be very similar to that. It's Instant Disk Recovery, so it's not the full image, but it is a particular disk itself. And then next you have Recovery for the entire virtual machine, or Restore Entire VM. So this only difference that you should know here is it's not that temporary state where the virtual machine can be powered on. Instead, this is going to do that full recovery from a backup directly back to the host, and then from there go ahead and be powered on. So it's doing that migration. The one other option that you'll see underneath restoring an entire virtual machine is when you hit next and you go into your restore mode, you have an option here to do something called a quick rollback. And this will allow you to restore change blocks only. So think if you've accidentally, or if you intentionally did an update of a workload and the update went bad, and now you just need to roll back to the specific changes or whatever it may be, you can leverage this quick rollback functionality here. Now, the other ones that you'll see in here is it starts to get a lot more granular. So restoring VM files, so think of the virtual machine config file itself, and then restoring guest files, so more within the guest operating system. So if this is a Windows server, right, I could go ahead and do a restore of just those particular files or recovering files from within Linux. If this was an application item, so think maybe if this was like my SQL server or Oracle server, I would also be able to do a recovery of that leveraging our application item explorers. So here we have these built-in explorers for AD, Exchange, SharePoint, SQL, OneDrive, Teams, and Oracle. So we can leverage these to mount that specific backup and grab those specific items from within those backups and recover those back to the application. Now, the last few options in here that you'll see is gonna be recoveries to cloud. So I can restore my workloads to Amazon as an EC2 instance, as a virtual machine within Microsoft, VM within Google Cloud, and Veeam will actually handle that conversion for you. And then following up from that, you have your options to move the data itself. So moving a backup chain from one to the other, or copying that backup, or even performing an export as well as a scan. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this brief overview of all the powerful restore options available in the Veeam Data Platform. Visit us at veeam.com today, download a free, fully functional 30-day trial, and see for yourself. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see the newest content as soon as it's released. Thanks for watching.